Well, Sunday morning, a little overcast and blustery, but Josh Cook won't be worrying too much as he sits on pole position for round 19 of the Dunlop Production Touring Car Trophy here at Croft. And the marshals all wrapped up warm. Cook on pole ahead of Adrian Churchill, with Tom Carnaby lying third from Rob Smith in the BMW. And the rear drive BMW should start again well, putting its power down better over the driven wheels than the front drive cars. And again, look at the white nose coming up behind Josh Cook, tucks in front of Adrian Churchill. And that's a great start for Josh Cook. Now, Cook needs a really big result here. How big? Well, there are 12 points for the win, plus one for the fastest lap. Two races remain, total of 26 points maximum on offer then. And Adrian Churchill is 24 points in front of Josh Cook. Well, slowing Joe Gerling there, we saw him slowing right down. Josh Cook leads, he needs the BMW to play its part. Rob Smith in second position. There's Tom Carnaby, two behind the number 28 car, Steve Johnson. And coming up through the order, Gary Duckman. After the first race retirement, Duckman only in third place in the championship. So now he is battling, not for the win, but for a runner-up spot. It may well be Josh Cook's McGann that he'll have to tussle with. Into Sunny 1 and Sunny 2, the pair of right-handers. Again, wheel-to-wheel, Tom Carnaby with the white highlights on the side of his black car squeezes by Steve Johnson. And that puts him into fifth position, Johnson in sixth, and in eighth position there, the blue and yellow Seat of Gary Duckman. And Duckman needs to make a lot of progress here. Joe Gerling's car seems to be back up to speed again now, the grey machine. And again, the battle for fifth, wheel to wheel at the hairpin. Eighth place, car number five, the blue and yellow Seat of Gary Duckman. Well, without any success ballast, he should make progress. Josh Cook, the race leader then, from Rob Smith and the BMW, and Adrian Churchill, third place. Here's the battle for sixth position. Tom Carnaby just in front of the red and yellow Seat of Joe McMillan and the blue and yellow Seat of Gary Duckman. Duckman on the inside in car number five. McMillan just hanging on in the number 14 machine as they come through the back chicane. Josh Cook still leading in the blue McGann from Rob Smith in the BMW, had his best result of the season in race one, where he took third place. Now he's gone one better, he's in second, and Gary Duckman into tower up the inside of Joe McMillan. So he moves into seventh place. Can he hold it on the exit? Heading up to the Jim Clark S's, yes, it looks like he can. And Adrian Churchill in the Astra here may well be happy to sit behind Rob Smith's BMW, but Tom Carnaby not happy to sit behind Steve Johnson. Dives inside at Sunny 1. And he claims back that fifth position. Looks like that is going to be an interesting battle for Gary Duckman to get involved with. And there is Gary Duckman in the number 5 Seat as they dive into the complex. This long, sinuous group of corners that leads up to the hairpin, where the right line suddenly becomes the wrong line. Duckman in the middle of the road, being defensive as well as trying to find a way by 28 Steve Johnson. Gets good drive on the exit, little less weight in the car, allows it to accelerate quicker. Well, here comes Duckman, looking for fifth position, but he can't get that far up. Can he get sixth place? No, he can't. Tom Carnaby still in fifth, and 28 Steve Johnson in sixth ahead of Gary Duckman. So this is very hard work indeed for the Seat driver, but again, as they come out of Hawthorne, he manages to use his better acceleration to squeeze by into the chicane. Now he is up to sixth place. Well, for Adrian Churchill, this isn't a worry. Gary Duckman really out of the championship hunt now. It's about Churchill trying to beat Josh Cook, and from where he is, as long as Adrian Churchill finishes the race in the points, then he will be champion from where he is now, and I'm sure he is very well aware of that. He just needs 2 points or more from this race, and he will be champion no matter what Josh Cook does. Big moment there, exiting the S's for Steve Johnson in the 28 car. And down the inside now, Dan Malone senses that Adrian Churchill is not working too hard at the back of Rob Smith's BMW. Pushes Churchill down to fourth spot. There's the Myerscough College entry. That's their Skoda Fabia. Phil Boland's driving that project as Rob Smith clings to second position. Now, it's all allowed Josh Cook to rush away, but for Cook, the trouble is that Churchill is still firmly in the points. The battle for second is on, though. Dan Malone looking to make second his own. Cook comes through the camera's view, and the battle is on. And Dan Malone has gone in the last couple of laps from fourth up to second place, pushing hard in a car that he is trying to sell so he can move on for next year. Rob Smith's BMW, you sense that they're very inspired now to continue the development work with that car. Meanwhile, on board with Kevin George, further back inside the top 10, Tom Carnaby in the black and white car, racing with Joe McMillan in the number 14 SAT, normally driven by Joe's brother Liam. Battle for second continues to rage. Rob Smith back in front in the BMW. And he got a good run there on Dan Malone into the complex. Malone slowing dramatically. Through has gone Adrian Churchill. Well, that's a real shame for Dan Malone from second to fourth. And I wonder if he'll continue. Ryan Bensley, a little further back, all out on his own. At Tower, the battle for second then. Last lap chance for Adrian Churchill. Does he want to pass Rob Smith's BMW for second place? Josh Cook still leading the race. And Gary Duckman in the pits, the team saying it's a broken drive shaft that has put him in there. Oh, and that is the number two machine of Tom Carnaby, a long way off. Left front wing is damaged. Does he run into the back of somebody? Has he just lost the bumper going off? Through the complex then, Josh Cook leading the battle for second and best result of the year for Rob Smith ahead of Adrian Churchill. Josh Cook wins it. Rob Smith in second, and third place is enough. Adrian Churchill is the 2011 Production Touring Car Trophy champion. Behind Joe Gerling, here's the battle for fifth. Joe McMillan's red and yellow Seat just from Kevin George. Well, what's left of the number two machine of Tom Carnaby? He's in trouble there, running over his own front bumper. He heads to the line. Ryan Bensley, car number seven, takes seventh place. Well, a dramatic race for the championship. Third place enough to gift Adrian Churchill the win at the end of the season. And Josh Cook's fifth race win means he's the championship runner-up.
Josh, the Renault was rocket propelled today.
Yeah, it's going well. Shame that Adrian's secured the championship already, but congratulations to him. I've done all I can this weekend, but it's a bit too late really with these podiums. Better to get them sooner in the season, but yeah, it's been a good weekend.
Yeah, I tried to make it as wide as possible. Got second place and just held on to it all the way through. Really, really pleased. We've worked so hard for that all year, and Derek and Wes have done a great job, thanks to them.
Adrian, congratulations, another title.
Yeah, thank you very much. Hard fought.
Certainly was. That white BMW was dodging in front of you the whole race.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, he drove well. He drove very fairly, as he did in the first race. You know, if I could have got past easily, I would have got past. I think we were quicker for sure, but, you know, we just had a job to do and wrap up the championship, and I just needed to finish, so there was no point, you know, taking any risks at all.
Josh Cook makes the random draw. Top four will be reversed for the final race.